Devos. That cat is tragic. Online savage, real life average. You know, I'm not a zoologist, I'm not anybody's veterinarian or anything like that, but I know a bird when I see one, and when one starts flapping on my screen, whether that's on my iPhone screen or whether that's on my TV screen, whatever it is, I want to go ahead and just dial animal control. So if y'all have the number for animal control so we can get Betsy Devos ass out of here, then please let me know before we even continue talking about this shit. Make sure that you're going over to patreon.com/AdrianExpression. I'm going to be releasing this Tuesday a new episode of the Expression Podcast that's going to be posted over there. So make sure you go over there, check it out. Let me know what you want me to speak about on the podcast episode. We can get right into it. Now, I just want to go ahead and start talking about Betsy Devos ass now. Just a disclaimer, I really don't care how her last name is supposed to be pronounced. I'm pronouncing it how I feel like it should be and how it rolls off the tongue. You know what I mean? Just like how the droplets, how she wants the droplets to roll off the tongue. Of these kids' tongues, so we can just pass it around in the goddamn classroom. Now, I wanted to say something really quickly, something really profound about Betsy Devos. Okay, so anytime that she speaks, at least to me, now I do call her a bird because, you know, anytime she speaks, she sounds like she has been smashing her head into a tree for, you know, consistently for a couple of hours at least. So, you know, she really does give woodpecker tease, right? So obviously when she comes swinging that beak around, I'm just like, sis, you know, I'm really tired of seeing your ass. Like, sis, I know your neck must be exhausted from all that, you know, she eating worms out the wood and shit. Yeah, I know you exhausted. And the reason I know you're exhausted because my eyes get exhausted every time I have to see your goddamn face, and my ears get clogged up every time that bullshit just, you know, spews from your mouth and enters into my ear canal. I hate it. I hate it so much. Now, if you're not aware, Betsy Devos told y'all asses, essentially, she went on to CNN for 10 whole minutes, at least that's the clip that I watched, and she just kept repeating the same nonsensical bullshit over and over and over again. And essentially what she was saying on there, and I'm just gonna do a little bit of Adrian paraphrasing, she said to get y'all snotty-nosed ass, you know, ugly ass kids in these goddamn classrooms. She said, I don't give a fuck about if they live or die or not. What you're gonna have to do is, and I saw on a really quick diversion, I saw on Twitter that some teachers, or I guess teachers, were told to prepare a template for when their students, like a letter template for when their students die. Okay, so that's what the people on the ground are dealing with, the staff and the students, that they're going to have to be dealing with. This is what the employees at the school, they're gonna have to be dealing with, right? So she, essentially what she was saying on CNN was, take y'all ugly ass kids into this goddamn school, and I don't care if they drop dead in their goddamn desks, okay? They're going to take their ass and they're going to learn some shit. Now, if you would actually not be aware of who Betsy was, for a split second, you would think that she had this just super passionate, you know, one that defies any type of logic. I mean, anything she says defies logic. But if you didn't know who she was, you know, you would think that she has this extreme passion for getting kids into the school and for them to learn some shit, even in the face of death. It's like when Jon Snow was standing there with one sword in the Battle of the Bastards. We already knew that his ass didn't stand a chance, but he was still standing there like a dumbass. And you can be as mad as you want to be at me for saying this, but he still needed his sister to come save his dumb ass. So, you know, it gives very much Game of Thrones plot, the way that we're about to see all this unnecessary ass death, if these schools open up. I want us to remember one thing about Betsy, okay? No matter how she bullshits, and she doesn't even do it well, no matter how she tries to act like she cares about your kids, about education, she doesn't, okay? She cares about the money that is involved in it. Betsy's whole goal is to destroy public education. And it definitely dates back to before 2019. Listen, in 2018, this is coming from the Washington Post, in 2018, when Republicans controlled both houses of Congress, Betsy advocated for heavy cuts to her own department's budget, along with the launch of a new $1 billion grants program that would provide some public funding for private school vouchers. Okay, but even the GOP in Congress ignored her proposed cuts and told her to sit her ass right on down. So what Betsy wants to do, she wants to take the funding that is going to or supposed to go to public schools and divert it to private schools. We even saw, and this is also coming from the Washington Post, that she was trying to push for coronavirus relief funds to be taken away from public schools and to be geared towards private schools. So we already know that that's the game that she likes to play. But for her to get up here and say, all y'all asses need to be in school, there's obviously something else going on there. And I say that because, you know, you remember what Trump said. Trump threatened that if schools do not reopen for in-person instruction in the fall, the federal government might withhold billions and billions of dollars that it sends to primary and secondary education each year. Betsy's silly ass later clarified that the federal government would not withhold public education funding entirely, but instead would convert the grants to schools and districts that don't open sufficiently into private education vouchers for families. But I think the law won't allow her to literally snatch up public funding and just place it into the hands of the private sector. I don't know. I think she'll encounter a little bit of trouble just trying to do it exactly like that. But still, that's, you know, we see that's her goal. We see that's her plan, is to literally take all the funding, watch the public education system crumble right before her unblinking, terrifyingly piercing eyes. What I find interesting about this, and we can tie this into Florida, but I find it very interesting that she has no plan. She's a whole education secretary with no plan. And, you know, before I even talk about that further, I think sometimes when we watch these interviews with these like crazy people, when we watch these interviews with these Trump ass lickers, that, you know, you hope, you just continue to watch to see if there will be any sliver of humanity, you know, rising up in them. Is it any empathy? Is it any, you know what I mean? Any human decency, just one time. You know, you watch it like, okay, girl, kids are dying. Children are gonna die. And then you watch this interview to see if sis is actually going to act like a human. And every single time, with multiple people just like her in that circle, in Trump's circle, every single time they prove over and over again, they are socio-goddamn-paths. Like, completely. And the reason I say that is because they're not gonna get their asses in these goddamn classrooms. Betsy gonna stay in what, I don't know how many dozens of yachts she has and how many different houses her silly rubber ducky in the face built ass has. She's not gonna get her ass in these goddamn classrooms. She's not gonna get her ass in these schools. She ain't stepped foot in a goddamn school before she got this position. So all this work now, and we wanna cut and, you know, not pay these people salary. All this work is gonna be with teachers, with the staff, with, you know, parents, and the students. The ones with the boots on the goddamn ground. And these people in their high lofty places making all these idiotic policy, if you even wanna call it that, you know, they're just standing around. And she came on there on CNN repeating herself because she did not have a plan. And the reason she didn't have a plan is because she didn't think it was important to have one. Like, if you're going to send these people to their goddamn death, at least, you know, coordinate which side of the graveyard they're gonna stand on, you know what I mean? Something. She didn't even have that. She didn't even have no last will and testament for these goddamn kids. When asked about the CDC recommendations, oh, well, you know, they're just recommendations, and every school will have different scenarios, and if a hot spot kind of happens to pop up in a school, a hot spot in a goddamn school with kids, you know what hot spots results in? Death. Sweetie, instead of listening to science, listening to scientists, instead of encouraging their brainless bases to wear a goddamn mask, you know what I mean? I think this week or last week was the first time Trump was even seen in one in public. Instead of doing the sensible things like supporting healthcare workers with whatever it is, funding and PPE, instead of encouraging testing, they've been doing the exact opposite. Discouraging testing, acting like science does not matter, acting like they don't know how viruses work. They've been doing the exact opposite. And then they get so angry. Oh my God, why aren't the schools open? These kids need to go back to school. Well, girl, we would be in the condition of many other countries, many other sensible countries, had y'all actually had any type of human decency, right? I honestly just want Betsy to kiss my ass, and I don't know if she would be able to with that long ass beak, okay? And, you know, I mentioned Florida. Florida recent, the recent report that I read about Florida said that they reached a new status of 15,000 cases per day. Now, while that is going on, right, and DeSantis, let me read what DeSantis said. He said, we're not going back, closing things. I don't think that's what's really driving it. people going to a business is not what's driving it. I think when you see the younger folks, I think it's a lot more of social interaction. So that's just natural. I don't know what that man is saying. So that, along with many other reasons, is why you're seeing such huge numbers in Florida. So while that's going on, Disney World, Disney theme parks, released this dystopian ad, and they just kept repeating in the ad, welcome home, welcome home. And they had all these goddamn employees over there with their mask on, and I guess they thought this shit was supposed to be inviting. And I know people are still gonna end up going, obviously. But they had all these workers there with their masks on and shit. While we have this huge ass number of cases, Disney said, fuck that shit. Our money is more important. We're not gonna pause this shit for a goddamn thing, especially if the state does not mandate it, DeSantis. And they said, we're getting money, bro, bitches. We're Disney, bitch. We're getting money, ho. step your fucking bank accounts up, girl, and get like us and have all your customers come in here and create a cesspool, and let's just all dance until Armageddon. It's not like my broke ass was going anywhere, but our passports are useless, can't go to no goddamn country. Them girls said, stay your sick ass over there. The girls say, Americans, you just stay your sick ass over. It just don't make no sense. You know what I mean? And like I say, it ties into the Betsy thing, because Betsy's not taking her ass in the classroom. And I promise you, these, you know, super rich, crazy ass, top of the level executives at Disney are not about to be walking around in a Disney goddamn park. Like, they're not about to do it. And I'm sure them, I bet they don't even have to come into the goddamn offices. I mean, on a normal day. So I can't even imagine. Of course they stand ass home and watching their bank accounts increase. Some girls said that American billionaires got $434 billion richer during the goddamn pandemic. But them girls didn't stop rent, and they tossed a $1,200 check to some people and said, you broke, sick, useless worker bee bitches, better just make it work for a whole year. This shit don't make no sense. So honestly, I just want people to know, I want people to understand that anytime Betsy DeVos speaks, you know, seeds come out of that beak, okay? And if you reap what you sow, you know, anything that grows from those seeds is gonna be given poison ivy. It's you're gonna get a rash, it's gonna itch, you're gonna scratch your skin off fucking around with Betsy bird ass devils. Like, it's just, that's it. Betsy gives me all kinds of, if it looks like a duck and quacks like a duck, Aflac. That's it. Betsy is so much a bird to me that I am 100% sure that her mother threw up in her mouth in order to feed her non-flying ass. That's just, it is what it is. Betsy looks like a human sacrifice that wasn't fully completed, a human sacrifice ritual that was not done correctly. And I guess in order to finish the ceremony, she wants to use America's kids as sacrifices. When in my opinion, the only thing that really needs to be presented to the universe as an offering are those thin ass strands of hair that are lodged in her soggy ass scalp. Get her off of my screen, get her out of my face, and get her out of office, period. Now, I was gonna talk about Chance the Rapper. I was gonna talk about Megan Thee Stallion hanging out with Kylie Jenner and stuff in this video, but I think I'm gonna save it for the podcast. I got a lot of requests to talk about on the podcast on Patreon already, so make sure you sign up so you can listen. Tuesday is definitely gonna be a lot of fun. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you so much for allowing me to rant and get that off my chest. I want someone to please make sure that you send Betsy back to her nest so she can stop flapping those mangled wings on my screen, and also so that we can have a good goddamn evening.